I posted something on Twitter a little while ago. I posted, Yankee Candle really nailed that new baby smell with their new placented candle. It's stupid. It's a dumb joke. You don't put the good shit on the internet. What can I tell you? Except an hour after I posted that, the official Yankee Candle Twitter account liked it. Then they immediately unliked it, probably when they actually read it, is what I have always assumed happened. It's like, someone's talking about us, we always like that. Jesus, what have I done? No. Except when someone favorites a tweet that you posted, Twitter emails you a picture of the tweet and the name of the account that just liked it. So I took a screenshot of that, started sending it off to Yankee Candle, just like, what are you trying to hide? What now? I have evidence. Hashtag Yankee Scandal. What's up? They did not respond to any of that. So now I tell this story on every stage in every city that I go to until I get the message to the fat cats in the big candle industry that I am not going to take your soothing, delicately scented bullshit anymore. I will settle out of court for 2 French vanillas. Those things smell delightful. Fucking great. I was reading an article on the internet recently, and it wasn't really an article. It was a series of pictures, and they had captions. But fuck it, that passes for an article nowadays, right? As well it should. I mean, we live in a world where you can download a Domino's Pizza app to your phone, press a couple buttons, you order your pizza over the internet. But wait, if you're not up for button pressing, now you can just speak your order and use your phone's voice recognition. It will translate it, turn it into cinna sticks and buffalo chicken kickers. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, you know, like a fucking telephone. You can use that same thing to call Domino's, say, I want pizza, and they'd bring it to you. But no, we don't speak to other human beings anymore. We've evolved past that. What we all want is to sit in one place, have a tiny screen that does everything for us, and move closer to our apparent goal of like being Stephen Hawking without any of the accomplishments that should make you wanna be Stephen Hawking. But this article was 25 hilarious autocorrect fails. Number 6 is so funny, you'll throw up in the shower tomorrow. Like, they always say that shit. And I'm always like, where's number 6? Gotta see this. This one, actually very funny. They weren't lying. It was an autocorrect fail. Text from dad. Said, do you want to come over for dinner tonight? We are eating your mom's pussy. Then he said, oh my god, I meant pot pie. Why did my phone do that? I was like, touche, BuzzFeed. That is very funny. But it's funny because no phone comes pre-programmed with the word pussy in it, you guys. Dad taught his phone that word. Because all he uses it for is just Google image search, pussy. Pornhub search, pussy. Text your mom, I want to eat your... She could have been making hamburgers that night. When he had H, it still would have suggested pussy. Because that is the only word he writes on there. The opposite has never happened. No dude has ever gone to jerk off and accidentally watched a video of hot, wet pot pie. No one has that fucking problem. Let's stay on internet porn. I had an interesting first this year. I used the share button. On one of those videos. Yeah, I don't like the share button either. Why does that exist? More importantly, what dude made them add that feature? He's creepy as shit. You know someone was just writing angry emails into Pornhub like, are you serious? When I want to show my friends what I touch myself to, I gotta copy and paste a URL? What am I, Amish? Like, why'd we give that dude what he wanted? But then I saw a video. Disclaimer, I didn't search for this video. I was going down a YouTube-style related video rabbit hole. Except with porn, it gets weird so much faster than it does on YouTube. 2 clicks in, naughty stepmom and sister teach son while dad's asleep on the couch. The dog's filming it. I'm like, Jesus Christ, man. I don't want to see that. I don't care how incognito Chrome says this tab is. I don't want... This video... Teenage Japanese schoolgirl and her older female Japanese teacher. They're both vomiting. Like, a lot. Like, neither of you should have come to school today, a lot. I don't even get how it was porn. They were both fully clothed. Nobody was naked, which the fact that I was made me even more uncomfortable. I was like, I don't like this. at all. They may have eventually gotten naked. I don't know, because about 45 seconds into that video, the student threw up on her desk. The teacher threw up in the student's hair. Yeah, and I was like, dude, I'm going to throw up. I cannot look at this anymore. Disgusting. Except, where's that share button? I'm sending this to everyone I fucking know. I can't wait, right? Now I get it. I did not use that button because I felt turned on. I used it because I felt like I had just watched a documentary on global warming and I had to help raise awareness this happens in our world. I can get behind a cause, so I'm happy to tell you guys, a portion of the proceeds from every show that I do now goes to help fund my subscription to TokyoPukeParty.com, so thank you so much for coming out tonight. You are helping those in need.